President Yoweri Museveni is currently in Kenya's capital Nairobi for a state visit at the invitation of President William Ruto. The president's visit aims at strengthening the long-standing bilateral relations between Uganda and Kenya and exploring new avenues for collaboration and mutual benefits. Yesterday, Museveni received a warm welcome at the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport by the delegation from the Kenyan government led by Dr. Musalia Mudavadi, the Prime Cabinet Secretary and Cabinet Secretary for Foreign and Diaspora Affairs. During his stay, the president will engage in high-level discussions with President Ruto and the other Kenyan government officials. The discussions will cover a wide range of topics, including trade and investment, infrastructure development, security cooperation, and regional integration. The leaders will explore opportunities for increased investment and collaboration, aiming to harness the full potential of the East African region. The delegation from Uganda includes Rebecca Kadaga, the first Deputy Prime Minister and the Minister for East African Community Affairs, among other dignitaries. The ex-Minister of State for Agriculture and Forestry under President Dr. Milton Obote's second government passed on last night. Professor Patrick Rubaihayo, also a former national chairperson of the Uganda People's Congress, died at his upcountry home in Wabare sub-county, Kashari County in Barara District. According to the family sources, he felt unwell after dinner before he was rushed to hospital, but unfortunately he breathed his last at the age of 84. Honorable Patrick Rubaihayo, a biotechnologist, returned to Makerere University after the collapse of the UPC government and has been teaching and conducting research on food production at University College of Agriculture and Environmental Sciences. He also represented Barara Central in the 4th Parliament of Uganda between 1981 and 1985. Counsel Peter Walubiri, a city lawyer and leader of one of the UPC's party factions, described him as a forthright nationalist who served his country well with dedication. He leaves a legacy. He was never a pretender and has died a UPC staunch. He was an academician. He served Makerere as a senior lecturer and other organizations diligently, Counsel Walubiri said. Herbert Vyoreko, the Western Regional UPC chairman and a young brother to the deceased, informed the reporter that the deceased will be laid to rest on Sunday at his ancestral home in Rabari, Kashari, Barara District. Mourners gathered yesterday for the funerals of victims of an attack on a camp for internally displaced people in Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo, which the government has called a war crime. The funerals were held in Goma, the main city in the northern Kivu province, which has been plagued by fighting between M23 rebels and the Congolese armed forces. 35 coffins were lined up for the ceremony at Goma largest stadium. Burials took place in Kibati, around 10 kilometers north of the provincial capital, in a special cemetery for victims of conflict. During the event, Fabrice Puela, Congolese Minister for Human Rights, assured citizens of security.
Nous tenons, chers compatriotes du Nord Kivu, à vous rassurer que personne ne permettra que ces aventures macabres et de mauvais augure puissent rester impunies. Un génocide congolais pour des intérêts économiques, génocide, est perpétré dans notre pays par le Rwanda.
On May 3rd, bombs struck huts in Mugunga camp for the displaced people on the outskirts of Goma. Humanitarian sources and an official from the camp put the death toll to 15, but the government minister said 35 people had died and 37 were injured.